Hey y'all, what it is, bitches. So I have not made a Love After Lockup review in a long time, bitch, because for one, I know a lot of y'all don't like my reviews anyway, bitch. Y'all get bored with me talking about shows. And for two, bitch, it just ain't been that damn interesting, bitch. But this new fucking part of their show, Life After Lockup, has gotten my motherfucking attention, bitch. And last night's episode was too explosive and ratchet as fuck for me to ignore and not make a fucking video about. So it starts off with Marcelino and Brittany, bitch. Okay, we all know that Marcelino went over to Tito's house to beat his ass because, you know what? In Marcelino's mind, he's beating up his neglected daddy's ass, okay? Now, Marcelino has so much trauma that he has not gotten over that he really thinks that beating up his wife's ex is really doing something good. This nigga went over there just to argue about their son. Honey, I don't care if you are married to Brittany. That's Tito's son, okay? He has every right to still have his motherfucking son. And I agree with Tito. I'd be dead if you take my fucking son full custody, bitch. Okay, I don't care if Tito was high. People were saying that Tito was high, but bitch, still a better daddy than Marcelino's old crooked ass, dramatic, trauma king ass, okay? Old scrawny ass, fake ass T.I., okay? So, you know, we start off the episode with just Marcelino and, you know, Brittany in the car. They're going to see the lawyer, and he's going to confess to the lawyer that he beat up Tito and that they're still trying to fight for custody. Girl, if I was Brittany, I'd leave that motherfucker. You ain't about to go over there and fight my baby daddy. I don't care how much fucking problems you got, daddy issues you got. You ain't about to fight my motherfucking baby daddy. Motherfucking bitch. So yeah, Marcelino, you need a lot of help. You just need to run to a therapist. Stop beating up these niggas. Go find a therapist, nigga. You have so much trauma and PTSD from your childhood that you have not resolved. You shouldn't even step to Brittany. Well, that's probably why you stepped to Brittany, because she's an inmate. She was an inmate and you felt like she was just gonna be so dependent on your ass. Wrong. Anyway, y'all, fuck them. They're boring anyway. They're like my least favorite couple. Let's get on to the next bitch. Girl, when I tell you that when Scott didn't take a blood drug test and Lizzie took a drug test and she was clean, I laughed out motherfucking loud. I'm like, this nigga has to be on some heroin. That's what I said before he confessed, was this nigga's on heroin. He's always sluggish. He's always, you know, kind of like his teeth is all rotten. His skin looks all dead and, you know, picked at. You know, he's all sluggish and just down, because we all know heroin's a downer. At least I know heroin's a downer. I'm like, either this nigga got an alcohol problem, he got a heroin problem, or he does pills. Because that's the only way you're going to look that bad and be that sluggish and down all the time. And lo and behold, bitch, he's like, I can't take it. I can't take a drug test, Lizzie. I can't pee. And she's like, tell me the fucking truth. I know you're a fucking crackhead. Scott, tell me the motherfucking truth, bitch. And Scott's old bitch ass starts crying. Well, Lizzie, you know when we broke up, I went crazy. And you know, I tried meth once, and I tried heroin once. Once, bitch, really? If it was just once, you wouldn't even be scared to take this test. Anyway, he goes on to say that he's been doing it on and off for the past few years since him and Lizzie broke up or whatever the fuck. And, you know, well, Lizzie's all like, I'm so shocked. Oh, I'm so hurt. Bitch, you're not hurt. You're not even in love with this nigga. Stop motherfucking lying, bitch. Why the fuck you lying? Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my God, stop fucking lying. Like, girl, you're not in love with him. You literally came back to his house just to see if he still wanted your ass. Just to see if you could still get some dollars out of him. Even though he broke now, bitch. You know your pussy washed up. We all know that. But you just went over his house, went all the way to California just to see if you still get him. Because you're a narcissist, bitch. But anyway, we're going to get to that later. So Scott just tells her how he was so depressed and, you know, he's been doing drugs on and off. And I really do feel sad for Scott, because Scott is really fragile. He has really low self-esteem. I can tell. He really looks for love in all the wrong places. And I feel like Lizzie's just abusing that. She's just like, okay, so what? Where's my new purse? Where's the money for my new purse, bitch? Lizzie, get your ass. Anyway, so I was not surprised though, y'all. I know Scott has been acting weird, you know. I mean, I know I'm an alcoholic, but like I can spot another addict. You know, I can tell if someone's on drugs or alcoholic. I can just tell if they have a problem, and he definitely has a problem. You know, he may have, you know, said that Lizzie made him go broke, but I really think his habit has made him go broke. So he shouldn't be putting all this blame on Lizzie. And there's one thing I can say. Lizzie is right. That bitch is on parole. She don't need to be living with nobody who does fucking meth. You know, as soon as the damn parole officer comes, they gonna be looking in the bathroom, see that there's meth and crack, and they see meth and crack, they gonna lock Lizzie's ass up. They ain't gonna lock Scott's ass up. Are you fucking kidding me? So she was right about that. But bitch, you need to fucking, you know, cut all ties with Scott. If you don't love him, you love that bank account, you love the fact that he was giving you attention, you love attention, you love money, that's what you love. You don't love Scott. There's no way you're attracted to Scott. You ain't even gave him no pussy, and it's worth the 3 fucking years. Are you kidding me? Okay, my next motherfucking couple that I hate so much, my second hatest couple besides Marcelino and Brittany, is motherfucking Andrea and Lamar. Okay, I like Lamar. Don't get it twisted, y'all. I like Lamar. Actually, at first I thought Lamar was just a fucking dusty ass nigga, but really Lamar is better than Andrea. Okay, so Andrea takes Lamar to Utah. They were on vacation, but this bitch starts doing some scheming shit. Okay, she starts stealing this nigga's debit card, stealing this nigga's ID, calling up the kids' schools, like, oh, can we come back, can my kids come back and enroll, you know, calling up her old boss, begging for another job so she can just entrap this nigga back to Utah. Nobody wants to live in fucking Utah, bitch. Are you serious, bitch? Only your ass wants to live in Utah, not him. No one wants to live. I don't want to live in Utah. Motherfucking homeless man up the street from my house would want to live in Utah. Nobody wants to live in fucking Utah, bitch. And you know, you're over here trying to, you know, force his Mormonism on this man who is a fucking gangster thug nigga from California. Are you fucking kidding me, bitch? If you wanted the Mormon man so bad, you should have married one of the Mormon motherfuckers up there in Utah, bitch. And I've been to Utah before, personally. Utah is like the sunken place. It is the creepiest place on earth. I've been there. This was years ago. I was in high school and I was there. I was like 17. I went to their like rest stop, and literally they looked at me and my family like we were fucking aliens. Like, they're like, what is that? Yeah, I felt so out of place as a black person there. Really, bitch? And I was in Salt Lake City, Utah. I wasn't even in the fucking outskirts where she's at. I was in the city. Nobody wants to live there, bitch. You over there trying to force a man to stay with your ass. You know what's funny, though? Lamar was like, yeah, you stay here in Utah, I'm gonna be free in California. That nigga don't want you, bitch. He married you for a place to stay. He thought that he could get a place to stay in LA, a free place to stay, you know, and a TV show and all this for you. And now you're being crazy. He don't want your ass. He does not want you. Find a man who wants your dinosaur looking ass. Find a man who wants your lashes that look like spider legs looking ass. Find a man who wants a bitch that's 500 pounds. Go find somebody like that. He ain't the one. Lamar is grown out of it, bitch. You know, he trying to do his rap career at 45. Bitch, he trying to be a rapper. He trying to go to school to be a motherfucking drug specialist. Drug dealing specialist, bitch. Not even in pharmacy, but like drug specialist. Bitch, he doing his online classes at ICDC college. He don't got time for your bitch ass in fucking Utah, bitch. You don't have to do this to get a man. You just find a man who wants a 500-pound woman. Find a man who wants a woman who lives in fucking Utah and nags all the time. Okay? Y'all are totally incompatible. You're a dumb bitch. Lamar deserves better. You know, Lamar deserves thousands of big booty hoes, and your ass needs to be alone with your fucking kids and so you can grow the fuck up. All I have to say about Clint and Tracy is that y'all both do crack. Y'all are both crackheads. You know, Tracy, you ain't clean. If you were clean, you wouldn't look like Scarecrow. Okay, if you had really gotten sober, you wouldn't still be looking like a Scarecrow. You would have gained all that weight back, bitch. I can tell you naturally thick. That crack just got you hella skinny, looking crazy out here, looking like a motherfucking Scarecrow out here in the fucking pumpkin patch in October, bitch. You look crazy. Clint look crazy too, talking to her like, yeah, at least I don't suck dick for rides. That's why I came right back. Your ass left right after our wedding. And you didn't come back for 2 weeks because I don't suck dick for rides, bitch. Get the fuck out of here. You've been dipping in her crack pot. You know, stealing all her motherfucking crack. You have no right to judge Clint. They're both too toxic. It's like Bobby and Whitney. The broke white version of Bobby and Whitney, okay? They just need to just fucking go to rehab together and just quit the show. Like, they're not even funny anymore. Clint just is cringy. Clint is abusive and cringy. He's talking all this shit to Tracy, talking about how she sucks and she sucks dick for rides and how she's a crack whore and all this shit. But still, you're able to renew your vows and get married to her. Like, you're a fucking abusive piece of shit. Tracy, you're still on crack. Stop lying. You're not sober at all. Y'all both don't need to worry about no damn vows. Y'all need to worry about going to rehab, bitch. Okay, it was just super cringy, super gross. You know, they both disgust me. When I look at them, I want to fucking vomit. So yeah. Okay, last but not motherfucking least, the most thirsty of all trios is Michael, Sarah, and Megan. Okay, Megan, bitch, listen to me. Listen, if you're watching this, bitch, listen. He is not trapped. He's a married man. He may have cheated with you, but he is not trapped. He's choosing to stay married with Sarah. He chose to nut in her again and get her pregnant right before he done popped your damn cherry, bitch. There's no entrapment there. This nigga chose to nut in that bitch. He chose to go up there to see his new daughter, bitch. And you're over here jealous. Oh my God, I can't believe the daughter's his. I can't believe he's going up there to visit. Like, you want him to be a deadbeat? Really? I mean, I think Mike's a piece of shit, you know, but damn, you want this nigga to disown his own newborn baby that's 2 weeks old, bitch? Michael must have a monster in his fucking pants, bitch. That motherfucker must have a 12-inch dick or something. Your ass is too damn stupid, Megan. You were damn near 30 over here, stigmatized, crying at old pictures of you and him, knowing damn well he married you up there with his wife and his newborn baby. You need some fucking self-esteem. Your daddy, he may seem nice on TV, but he failed your ass. You slow as shit. You desperate, slow as shit. You need to worry about losing 50 pounds. You need to worry about getting them ugly ass braids out your head and putting on a nice wig. You need to worry about finding a man that's not on parole and not married. That's in good old Texas. You don't need to be worried about some motherfucker across the country who is attached, okay? Get the fuck out of here, you stigmatized ass dumb bitch, okay? You too old for this, okay? You're 30 acting 20. Not even 20, you're acting 15, bitch. You're acting like I know you just lost your virginity, but come on, grow up. Sarah, if you really wanted to divorce him, you could have fucking sent them papers. You didn't have to bring the damn kids. You didn't have to get into a shitty argument. You should have just fucking sent the papers as is, bitch. You're not serious. I know damn well you're probably gonna get pregnant with him by next week, bitch. You're probably over here riding his dick right now as you're watching this damn video. You're not serious. You need to get some self-esteem, too. And as for Michael, you need to fucking stop playing with these bitches' feelings. You know goddamn well that this is an ego boost for you. It's an ego boost for you to have a wife and a side bitch both waiting on you hand and foot. It's an ego boost for your little narcissistic bitch ass, okay? All y'all three are both sick. All three of y'all are fucking sick, and y'all need to go to run to a therapist, bitch. With Marcelino and with Clint Tracy. All y'all just need to all join them in rehab. Okay, girl. That episode was just too much. Even talking about it, I'm like exhausted mentally and physically. So yeah, comment below what the fuck y'all think about this fucking episode. Crazy schemes or whatever the fuck it was called. Anyway, y'all. Bye.